in southern Wisconsin, and especially in urban areas, there's road crossings every couple hundred of feet, and even in the rural sections, we have road crossings every mile. And these could be major fish barriers, and there's a lot of them across the states. Tom, in this particular setting, you use some very innovative techniques to help fish pass through a particularly long culvert. Want to talk about those a little bit, explain what was done?
Sure. The challenges were that, yes, the culvert had to be extended because the slopes had to be more gradual and safer for roadway for requirements along the project new roads. And as because of that, the culvert had to be about 100 feet longer. And but since it's a new culvert, we had a lot more alternatives. We negotiated the size, and the size in this case was a mixture between trying to provide an adequate bankfull channel as well as pass the 100-year flood, and or the 1% chance probability flooding event. And in addition to that, we're able to embed the culvert. So what we're standing here on is a coarse aggregate fill mixed with some fieldstone boulders to provide a more stream simulation, a more natural channel through this culvert, to providing areas for resting areas and in macroinvertebrates and food base and such. And then in addition to that, the wing walls are always a real challenge, because in this case it's hard to see, but there's a concrete apron here, and the wing walls, it extends all the way out. And so typically that's not part of the stream design, so you can immediately have an impediment for passage if that channel is allowed to go out 25 feet. In this case, when the channel really is about 6 foot, 10 foot wide. And so we were able to recreate a channel you can see around us here on top of the concrete apron, as well as tie it in with the wetland mitigation design. So time will tell how well this functions with the higher flooding events, but we did survive the high flooding event this past July, I believe. So this whole site was underneath water, and so it functioned very well.
Yeah, and I think that had like a 1 in 500 chance of occurrence in any year, so really big event. And so when this has water flowing through it after rainfall events and such, those boulders, they give the fish a little bit of resting space as the higher velocities are passing over them, so they can make their way up the culvert.
Right, yeah, absolutely. And it also helps provide some larger substrates to keep, you can't just fill it with the smaller stuff, and it tries to key it all together and as one cohesive unit through the whole length of the culvert. It helps give it strength for those higher flow events that can get pretty erosive.